So we are going to talk about random walk with restarts and personalized PageRank. And this will be extensions of our initial PageRank idea that we have just discussed. So let me give you an example how this will be very useful. So we are going to talk about a problem of recommendations. Imagine you have a set of users, customers, and a set of items, perhaps products, movies, and then you create interactions between users and items by basically saying a given user perhaps purchased a given item or a given user watched a given movie, right? So this is now our bipartite graph representation here of this user to item relation. And then what we wanna do is somehow measure similarity or proximity on graphs. Why is this useful? This is useful because if you are an online store or if you are Netflix, you wanna ask yourself, what items should I recommend to a user who, you know, purchased an item Q? And the idea would be that if, you know, two items P and Q are purchased by a lot of similar users, a lot of other users have, let's say, bought or enjoyed the same item, the same movie, then whenever a user is looking at item Q, we should also recommend item P. So now, how are we going to quantify this notion of proximity or relatedness of different items in this graph? So the question is, for example, if I have this graph as I show here and I have items, you know, A and A prime and B and B prime, the question is which two are more related? So you could, one thing to do would be to say, you know, let's measure shortest path. So A has a shorter path than B to B prime. So, you know, A and A prime are more related. However, the issue becomes is that you could then say, oh, but if I have another example, let's say this one where I have C and C prime, and now C and C prime have two users that both, let's say, purchased these two items, then C and C prime intuitively are more related, are at closer proximity than A and A prime, right? So now the question is, how would I develop a metric that would allow me to kind of say, aha, it's kind of the shortest path, but it's also about how many different neighbors you have in common and how many different paths allow you to go from one to another. And the idea here is that PageRank is going to solve this because in this third example, you know, if you just say, let's count common neighbors, then let's say C and C prime are as related as D and D prime. And again, this is perhaps intuitively not what we want because, you know, item D, this user has enjoyed a lot of different items as well. This other user has enjoyed a lot of different items there. So this relationship is less strong than the relationship here because here it's really two items, that's all there is. So, you know, how could we capture this mathematically, algorithmically to be able to run it on networks? And this is where the notion of extension of PageRank happens. So PageRank tells me the importance of a node on the graph and ranks nodes by importance. And it has this notion of a teleport where we discussed that a random surfer teleports uniformly over any node in the graph. So now we will first define a notion of what is called personalized PageRank, where basically the only difference with the original PageRank is that whenever we teleport or whenever the random walker teleports, it doesn't teleport anywhere in the graph, but it only teleports, jumps back to a subset of nodes S. Okay, so basically we say, you know, there is a set of nodes S that are interesting to the user. So whenever the random walker teleports, it teleports back to that subset S and not to every node in the graph. And then in terms of, proximity in graphs, you can now take this notion of a teleport set S and you can shrink it even further and say, what if S is a single node? So it means that the random walker can walk, but whenever it decides to teleport, it always jumps back to the starting point S. And this is what is called a random walk with restart, where basically you always teleport back to the starting node S. So essentially, PageRank, personalized PageRank, and random walk with restarts are the same algorithm with one important difference. that in PageRank, teleport set S is all of the nodes of the network all having equal probability. In personalized PageRank, the teleport set S is a subset of nodes, so you only can jump to the subset. And in random walk with restart, the teleportation set S is a simple node, is simply one node, and that's the starting node, our, you know, query node item Q from the previous slide. So let me now talk more about random walks with restarts. So the idea here is that every node has some importance, and the importance gets evenly split among all edges and pushed to the neighbors. And this is essentially the same as what we were discussing in the original PageRank formulation. So in our case, we are going to say, let's have a set of query nodes. This is basically the set S. And let's now physically simulate the random walk over this graph, right? We will make a step at random neighbor and record the visit to that neighbor. So we are going to increase the visit count of that neighbor. And with some probability alpha, we are going to restart the walk, which basically means we are going to jump back to any of the query nodes and restart the walk. And then the nodes with the highest query, highest visit count will have the highest proximity to the nodes in the query nodes set. So this is essentially the idea. So let me now show you graphically, right? So we have this bipartite graph. Imagine my query nodes set Q is simply one node here. Then we are going to simulate really like a random walk that basically says I'm at Q, I pick one of its links at random and I move to the user. Now I am at the user, I pick one of the links at random, move to the other side, and I increase the visit count one here. And now I get to decide, do I restart, meaning go back to Q, or do I continue walking by picking one link to go to the user, pick another link to go back and increase the visit count. And again, ask myself, do I want to restart or do I want to continue walking? So the pseudocode is written here and it's really what I just say. It's basically, you know, pick a random neighbor for start at a query, pick a random user, pick a random item, increase the visit count of the item, pick a biased coin. If the coin says let's restart, you simply jump back to the query nodes. You can jump uniformly at random to any of them, or if they have different weights, you can sample them by weight. And that is this notion of a random walk with restart. And if you do this, then you will have the query item, and then you will also get these visit counts. And the idea is that items that are more related, that are closer in the graphs, will have higher visit counts, because it means that the random walker will visit them more often, which means you have more common neighbors, more paths lead from one to the other. These paths are short so that the random walker does not decide to restart, and so on and so forth. And this allows us to measure proximity in graphs very efficiently. And here we are measuring it by actually kind of simulating this random walk physically, but you could also compute this using the power iteration, where you would represent this bipartite graph with a matrix M. You would then start with a rank vector to have a given value. You would then transform the stochastic adjacency matrix with the teleportation matrix, and then run power iteration on top of it, and you would converge to the same set of node importances as we show here by basically running this quick simulation. So what are the benefits of this approach? This is a good solution because it measures similarity by considering a lot of different things that are important, right? It considers how many connections or how many paths are between a pair of nodes. What is the strength of those connections? Are these connections direct or are they indirect? It also considers the degree of the nodes on the path, because the more edges it has, the more likely is for the random walker is to kind of walk away and don't go to the node, let's say, that we are interested in. So in all these cases, this is very has a lot of properties that we want. It's very simple to implement, it's very scalable, and works really well. So let me summarize this part of the lecture. So basically here we talked about extensions of PageRank. We talked about classical PageRank where the random walker teleports to any node. So, you know, if I have a graph with 10 nodes, then it's teleport set S. You can think of it as it includes all the nodes and each node has an equal probability of the random walker landing there. This is called PageRank. Then the personalized PageRank, sometimes also called topic-specific PageRank, is basically the only difference is that now the teleport vector only has a couple of non-zero elements. And this now means that whenever the random walker decides to jump, you know, 50% of the times it will jump to this node, 10% to this node, 20% to this one and that one. So that's what is called personalized PageRank. And then random walk with restarts is again PageRank, but here the teleportation vector is a single node. So whenever the surfer decides to teleport, it always teleports to one single node. But mathematically, all these formulations are the same power iteration can solve them. We can also solve, for example, especially the random walk with restarts by actually simulating the random walk, which in some cases might be faster, but it is approximate. And the same algorithm works, only thing is, how do we define the set S, the teleportation set? So to summarize, a graph can naturally be represented as a matrix. We then define the random walk process over the graph. We have this notion of a random surfer moving across links together with having a way to teleport out of every node. This allowed us to define this stochastic adjacency matrix M that essentially tells us with what probability the random surfer is going to navigate each edge. And then we define the notion of page rank, which is a limiting distribution of the surfer location. And this limiting distribution of the surfer location represents node importance. And then another beautiful thing happened is that we showed that this limiting distribution can be computed or corresponds to the leading eigenvector of the transformed adjacency matrix M. So it basically means that by computing the eigenvector of M, we are computing the limiting distribution of this random surfer. And we are also computing this solution to the system of equations of flow equations, where the importance of a node is, you know, some of the importances of the other nodes that point to it. So all these three different intuitions, so the linear algebra eigenvector eigenvalue, the random walk intuition, and this links as votes intuition are the same thing. They all boil down to the same optimization problem, to the same algorithm, to the same formulation that is solved with this iterative approach called power iteration.